G'day all, welcome to part two, setting out. So I've got the stakes on the outside perimeter, got them run around. Now I'm gonna run the cross strings, find the intersections of the other six pier positions in the middle, I'll stake them. And then from that, with a laser level, I'll be able to get the height I require to order for every pier. I'm a little bit unwell at the moment, but we soldier on. We keep pushing through and we get it done. Okay, let's do this. This would have been more than enough to string out this set out. I'm not going to say the brand. Did the math. Even stretched with the tails, maybe 90 meters. 100 meters should have been enough to do the whole lot. Lesson learned. Because the fact is, I just had to drive a 1 hour round trip plus the time in the shop to get myself some more string just to finish this job. Sometimes just enough isn't enough, especially when you're remote. Anyway, let's finish this. So for our build, this, let's measure it off. 113. So this spot here is critical for our build, because here is going to be, right in here, a self-contained composting toilet. And there's a minimum height that's required for clearance. So I'm going to take it from the bearers because I'd like it to protrude a little bit on this side. Pardon me, under the bearer. And that way the sun will heat up the liquids to evaporate off. I've already set up the laser level to give me that clearance. Just double check it. There. So yes. So if I take everything from that, that should work out well for us. I've got my grid layout. I'll show you it. Very simple grid. A1, B1, C1, etc., etc. I'm going to write the heights that I need for every single one of these. Let's go. One final check to make sure everything is as I would want it to be. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That gives me room to move. I'm happy. Okay. So this one is, double check, yep. 300. Five fifteen. Four 70. 300 minus 100 equals 200. So now I've just got to put some screws in the centers of each of those inner stakes, and we're all good to go. Another handy tip, people, don't let your measuring tape slam. Be nice to it. There is a reason for this little bit of play, and every time you slam it, it degrades the measurement. Have a cuppa, come back, double check. So there you go, we're all set out. Got every one of my piers marked with a peg. That's where we've got to dig down for the concrete. I've measured the heights of every pier so I know what lengths I need to order. Got a long way to go. Anyway, the next step is with the auger, dig in 26 holes. See if I can do it by hand. Otherwise, I'm going to have to hire a machine and pour concrete. That's going to be special. Very slow progress, but I'm happy with the progress. It looks a bit confusing because I've got the low string, which was just to get the grid reference for the inner pegs, where the higher string is the horizontal string that I got my squaring off. So every corner peg is squared. Then I've measured out both directions to confirm that the pegs on the run, the piers, are in the right position. And once I was happy with that, then I did my cross stringing. Doesn't look like much, but this will be our home sweet home. Away from it all.